Hello everyone, welcome back to Let's Play Oblivion. Oops, I bumped into my microphone. Moving things around. I'm actually using a different screen. Found out my screen that isn't a gaming monitor is actually better than the one that is a gaming monitor, so yeah. Oh, you were moving around. Alright. So, I was going to head straight to the Imperial City. Sorry, I'm hungry again. But I forgot and was reminded that that orc in the arena wanted me to check something out, and it's so close here right now that I may as well just go ahead and change. Oh, hello. There's a Oh, but you know, this one, the Daedra only liked it someone on certain days. Unlike in Skyrim, where you can just talk to them after a certain level. Which is kind of awkward. Oh well. It may represent a change in the rules of the Covenant, actually. Anyways, yeah, let's head to Crowhaven. My companion. Where did she go? Did I fire her or something? Oh, goodness. Getting those things again where they just leave me. Ugh. Nope. Okay. Well. Alright, I guess I'll just go there alone. Whatever. What? Oh, hey, well, your body looks right. Aha! Uh-huh. Oh, man. I think I actually fixed some of the body issues. You're a jerk. I guess red guards don't like friends, jeez. Or that guy's just a dick. Probably. Right. Let's see, Crowhaven. And to you. That dark elf is nice. Who else are all? We have a gold mine here or something. Who are you? Bard guard. Oh, what's up with this? Barter. Hello. Oh, goodness. Enhanced kind of this. Oh crap. Okay, we'll sell that. Yeah, looks like that's it. Yeah, about that. Oh, okay. Right. Alright. I should stop delaying and get right to it. And this isn't the right way. These are like server quarters, I think, right? There's a well here, though. See, I recently used the Oscape tool to try and rebuild the lot and the height match and everything, so hopefully that means there won't be floating rocks and trees everywhere. That's my hope, anyways. Oh. Well, I say that, and then I look off to the right, and what do you know? So, that's my luck. Ends the brakes. Trying to fix that. It's not fixing. Oh well. I feel like I shouldn't wander the wilderness, because... Is it a mage? It's a mage in the distance, isn't it? Maybe? You know what? I'm gonna save it just in case. Alright. Because it's actually really, really incredibly dark on my screen. God, I really don't want to approach them. Hey, little stranger. Who are you? Death? What the hell? That's his name? Okay, Gigawolf, no. No, not the horse. Please, not the horse. Ah, screw you. Jeez. Oh, cool, okay. I hate these things. Why are they so gigantic? Horse, where'd you go, horse? Wait, there you are.
I know what I mean. Because,
well, for me, it's really, really freaking dark.
Oh, goodness. Alright. Well, you know what? That's better than absolute pitch black darkness.
Oh,
man. You are so nearly dead. I really shouldn't be riding you out here. Well, let's go and see who this thing is. Cause they're probably going to attack me as soon as I talk to them. I just saw it.
And now I... You know what? Oh crap, my night eye wore off. I'm blind. Help. Oh, I have torches.
Why did you forget I have torches? And I forgot the hotkey. Alright, so maybe I can't. Nope, I can wield a torch. Goodness. This is really not the time to travel, huh? And I know once I get up there. God, I'm still freaked out by the NPC called Death. Somehow I'm not gonna talk to that. Nope. Nuh-uh. That's all kinds of nope.
I mean,
goodness, it's so dark for me out here. I actually don't know.
Shit. No! Stop attacking the horse! Jeez,
flare, searing flare,
weak fireball.
No, that'd kill my horse. Oh, crap. Burning mana. This would probably help right now, too. Man, I wish I could really heal my horse!
No! No! Horsey! Ah! Oh, that's the second bloody horse, you bastard! Jesus! Ah! No! Oh! No! Horse! Oh, man! Damn it! There's no way I can take all this back to town. Damn. We're gonna try.
Man, oh, poor horsey. I mean, Thunder. Thunder Mark 2. Oh, God. Oh, dang. Nope. Not possible. Not possible at all. Okay.
Damn.
Oh, well, that made it awkward, but I wanted my saddlebags back. Okay, I'm gonna have to drop a bunch of stuff, like, oh goodness, I don't want to drop this armor, though. Look at how much I can sell it for. Oh, I should've just
ran to Anvil, or traveled to Anvil, slept, and then sold this stuff off.
Crap. That'll teach me. Alright. That's just enough, and we're pretty much gonna have to walk. Goodness. Oh, jeez, yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna have to walk all the way to Anvil. Somehow. It's so dark for me.
Yeah, you know what? I'll go ahead and pull my torch up.
can do some healing. Should I try and talk to Death now? You think? I mean,
Oh, you know what? I
can't. No. I wish I could have the, Oh, okay, I'm stuffed. Oh, goodness. They just love killing the horse. Why the horse? I have no idea, but... Oh, God, here's Death. Alright, you know what? We're gonna talk to it. Or him. Whatever it is. Alright, I need to get rid of some of these. Oh, I do have a quick save. Oh, but using quick saves is such a buggy thing. Can I have your horse, man? Blinky? You're really cool. Whoa! Jesus! Okay. A pewter spoon. I'm gonna take this. Oh goodness, I can't really afford to be. What? I will fight you to the death. I have to. Alright, well. Yeah, let's go ahead and get out of here. He said be gone. So we're not gonna mess with him. Goodness, I should actually probably get to the road, huh? Oh. Jeez, I lost the horse. I should probably include some kind of horse counter. Holy crap. It's so dark. And I dropped my torch again. So. Then take that out. Oh, goodness. Oh, my poor Thunder. Thunder Mark II. I hope I'm heading. Yep, that looks like the right place, actually. Goodness. You know, the time scale is ridiculous on this. In Oblivion, I would like to set it to like something like 10, 20, maybe. Something. Something different. A lot slower than what it is, because days fly by. Holy crap. Oh, I see some lanterns. Oh, goodness. We've made it all the way there, and of course, a troll attacks. Stupid trolls. Ah, I hate trolls. Hate them as much as I hate vampires. Oh goodness, see, I'm collecting things, and I really can't afford to collect them. But... Oh man, and the horses here are expensive. Uh-oh. Aw, jeez. Alright, it looks like we're back to just walking. Oh, that's kind of sad. Oh boy. You know what? Maybe I have a potion for this. The tea! Yes. Hmm. Somebody added a few, signs, yes. Oh. Mithril armor, is that? What? I think the horses here are like 4,000? 4,000 septons. I wish I had that much. Wish I had enough for a boat. I'd forgo the horse. Pardon me, horse. I need to get in. Oh, goodness. It's been a while since we've been in Annabelle. What are you doing? Evening. What? I just heard someone get hurt. Goodness.
Goodness, goodness. Okay. We're there. Finally. Finally. Alright. Oh, goodness. Okay, this is the right place. Good. Wow. This is Count Arms. That's a change of tone pretty quick, ain't it? Sure. Well, I'm done talking to you. Hello? Soothsay decree? What? Since time immemorial, Khajiit have roamed Tamriel, long before the First Empire was founded, even. Yet in recent decades, shortly after the 5-year war between Valenwood and elsewhere, the so-called Soothsay decree was issued, which does nothing other than disallowing most Khajiit to live elsewhere. To leave. Duh. Oops. What most people born after the miracle feast don't know is that the citizens commonly labeled as Khajiit are only a few of 17 variants, which is to say, Soothsay and Soothsay Ra. The variants include Palmer, which are similar to tigers, Cathay Ra, Jaguarmen, or the elf-like Bones. Rumors persist that Valenwood and Somerset insisted on the law mostly because of them, for fear of Khajiit spies looking like Bosnia. The other common variants still allowed to live in High Rock and Hammerfell are the Ohms Rock. They're often described as looking like a mix of human and Khajiiti creatures. They're also not allowed to live in Cyrodiil or most other provinces.
That's a weird law. These are some weird laws. What the heck?
But the Soothsay decree has come under attack lately. An Ohms Rock who doesn't wish to be named said it's apish. Honest Ohms can't come to Cyrodiil under legal terms, yet any scoundrel can pass as Bosman and do whatever he wants. It's only hurting law-abiding citizens. As if a spy would identify them himself. When asked about the other forbidden form, she replied, an Ohms rot can be shaved even if it's going to be a major illness. A Degi will pass as a usual wildcat, and the Senshra, I'd like to see the guards standing in one's way. A logic which cannot be questioned. Okay, let's not question them. Just a few weeks ago, several citizens of the Imperial City reported seeing an Ohmsra living on the outskirts. Yet an investigation by the Imperial Watch turned up nothing. A merchant who doesn't want to be named told us that she sold a lot of shaving equipment just days before. Weird. Alright. Get a room for the night. I'd like a bed for the night. I'll take it. Oh, thank you. Oh, you know what? Ooh, cow's milk. Oh, but it's expensive. But I have to afford a horse somehow. Somehow? That she's real. Do they have figs? Oh, they're so expensive. So... You know what? The chest is here. Good, good. What? What just test? Oh. I heard somebody pissing. Freaked me out. Anyways. Ignoring me. Oops. Bounce on. Oh, hello. What's all this then? Oh. Nope, this is not my room. Well, that's odd. New faces in the Mage's Guild. Googlash Grom was gone. Our first visit to the new orc in the Mage's Guild has been rather confusing. Our reporters looked for her helplessly in the Mage's Guild Naville, co-workers advising us to look for her up to the third floor where she often meditates, but we ended up finding her in the Fighters Guild Hall, where she was just getting up from a nap. At least that way, she was easy to spot amongst others with her robes and her... Wait, where is she in the Fighters? The enthusiastic and energetic workwoman then invited us to the finest local tavern, and along a very efficient talk. Oh my goodness, is this... Oh. Such as a... Okay, she's... I mean, if you guys want to read, you can pause it and do that. I'm gonna skin it. Frizz? This haircut's not that bad, but it's still very well. No. Small ball of doom. I'm going to have a conversation. It's all the same. It's just... Wow. Aging? Oh. Very timely. Goodness. Okay. Alright, it just has some funny name spells. Okay. I don't have money for spells, but... Ah, the chest. Hello. Luggage. I missed you. I missed you, luggage. Oh, and I left. This. Oh, wait. Aloe vera. Still have my... That was in there. Alright, that's it. Let's go ahead and get some sleep. 8 hours will do. Okay. So we've lost the horse, and now we have to get a new one, and we'll have the money for it.
Oh,
boy. Well, I certainly like a challenge, I guess. It's nice to see that there's complimentary food with the room. And you want to say. Alright. There we go. Good. I know, I need to save a lot more often. I don't want to rely on too many. Okay, hold on. Not anymore. Hello. Let's see. Oh, pretty. Famous fellas. Well, looks like I got the dark elf body wrong. I'll have to fix that. Okay. Oh, right, you're the little rat lady. Oops. Oh, well. Alright. Onward and forward to... Morvane's, yep. Morvane's a good, blacksmith? Arms dealer? You know, that sort of thing. Stairs, weird. Let's do that. Oh, but he's got the right body. That's weird. Okay, he's pretty happy with me. You still have some meat. Oh, what is this? Oh, that's... Ooh, hello. Argonian longsword. Oh. Well, this isn't the time to upgrade my weapon, is it? Oh. I mean, some of the time isn't doing too bad. So, shall I remember? Oh. Oh, well, you know what? Actually, first we'll go ahead and use some hangers for you. Four? You think four will suffice? Oh, good God. No, I'm not. That's a horrible price on four hangers. Stop. Hmm. What? Huh. Oh man. Oh, come on. Oh jeez. I want a full price for these. So you say that, but then I look at your repair hammers and they're just like you're just trying to overcharge me for some jeez. Or run out of money just trying to repair these things. I should get some decent money out of them though. Oh, look at that. And I only broke one on all of that this time. I'm terrible at smithing.
I swear.
I'm not a smith. I don't like smithing. I'm sure there is, actually. Honestly, some of these are really nice. And, Do you hear a lot of things? Hello. Oh, it's too many. Oh, you only got short swords, really? It's long knife. Crunching on some machine. Jeez! What's this? Oh, that is one. Okay. Yes. So, do I? Yeah, really. Yes. For you, maybe. Why? You need back. And then some. Okay. Good. That's all I really got for you. I don't want to sell this. This is just way too nice. Instead, it's only got 76 uses. You know what? Honestly, I will, Morvay. I will. You're really good at your game. You have really bright eyes, my friend. Alright. What else should we do here? We've got 1600. Not enough to buy a horse and anvil. I'm gonna travel all the way back to Coral and get a horse. A cheap horse, but. Sure. What did you eat? Whoa! Your teeth are slicing through your face! Oh goodness! Whoa! Hello. Ooh, ah, oh, Jesus, so expensive though. My home, but you know what? It's early morning. We'll go ahead and just walk to Crowhaven. Should be good. Daydream more popular, Skyrim Gates lower, Anvil Tarts Ported, Skyrim of Freedom, these plaguing Anvil's manifold has finally been broken. These shameless women employed feminine wiles to seduce men. Oh, hey, this, yeah, I helped you do this, didn't I? In the world, my will may rest easier. Cool. Only Morbane would offer me better prices if I did that, but I didn't personally help him, really. Hey, what is this? What is this one? Ugh. Okay.
Seems that the guard names don't apply to the TBS Day guards, I think.
You're not my horse. I wish you could be my horse. Howdy. Lost my horse, so, you know, a horse without, or an adventurer without a horse is just not a good thing. It isn't. Look at all these horses, too. Okay. There's one thing. Fine. Jeez. These horses, I'm pretty sure, cost 4,000. Yes. Ooh. $4,000 gold. You know what? I'm pretty sure even. Even talking to that thing. That's weird. What? Makes me want to say. And that. And that. One. Save. Oh, yeah. Okay. I didn't think they'd actually lower the price even if I was their friend. They do seem, they really don't like Bretons. Seems. Red guards for anyone, Oh, wait, what is this? Oh! Ah! And you probably could have helped fight the woods. Anyways, looking back this way. Here we go. Come on, we're scaling, come along. Oh, jeez. Okay, I have no idea what it's doing. I probably screwed up the height map somehow. I'm generating them. That happens, but it happens. There's another method I can use. It's a little less. Not Oscape. The TES for QLOD or something. It'll generate height maps and everything. Jeez. Of course, those could be floating just because the landmass hasn't floated yet, which. That's kind of annoying, you know. I don't really want to see all those. There's some staring directly at them. Oh, you finally fell apart, did you? Oh, right. Where is it? Oh. Yeah, I mean, it's a gentle fade in, right? Maybe anyways. I mean, there's some jarring stuff, you know. I'm sure I can fix it somehow. I'll figure it out. Ah, the one I was looking for. What gulp am I to die? Many things. Oh, I don't want to scream at you. Many times I imagine you all do. Although, this is why. Where you come in, I've heard of a potion that. Oh, it would upset my inner routine, my daily clock, my sweet nature. Okay. Eh, wouldn't it be good? No! The potion is said to be formed from the combination of 7 unique filters. As if that wasn't bad enough, they have made him believe he can only eat hay made from very sweet psychedelic grass. It was first discovered in a place called Thebes, in another world entirely. Somehow the filters fell through a wormhole in the multiverse. Holy crap, what even? Now they're here in the Citadel. How nice. Not nice at all. Do not believe the rumor, but I must find out for sure. Fetch me the pillars, and we will see if you become immortal. If not, I can arrange for you to be permanently dead. The choice is yours. Something called death with no face. I'll help you. I don't feel like I really have a choice. Do you agree? Now I can use my not inconsiderable strength power to locate these damn things on your map. The Trastuses that any of them are to match, plus the Fort Lynchel, okay, goodbye. And now, to just kind of slip away, we have a quest from Death. And apparently he's offering me immortality? Which, that does sound... I don't know. Oh, jeez. Those trees are loading in way too far away. I wonder if I can fix that, actually. With saying... That's not it. In video. I don't know. Yeah, that's just my messing with my lodge. Broke it a little bit. A fair bit. Anyways. Well, the troll's gone now. I mean, what else could be here, right? You know, I hope Agronet pays me. I hope he pays me well. Because I lost my freaking horse! Oh, and then I have to go all the way to the Imperial City anyways to, get them their Master Stonemason, I think? Well, where are you? You are hard to see. Oh, what? Oh, okay, there's more than one. Good job, Skelly. Good job. Come on. Did I repair my sword? Because I forget. Oh, jeez. Okay, yep. You're repaired. And it's a heavy sword. It is Dwemer. Alright. Goodness. I'll definitely have to fix the lodge at some point. Hopefully between episodes at some point. I don't know, I'm probably gonna do a bunch of these in a row. I'm still trying to get to a certain amount of videos before I actually release them. Oh, I've entered Crowhaven. Somewhere inside, I will unlock the truth that Agronet Crow Malog is searching for. I should be cautious, however. The fort has long since lost its local trappings, and the presence of evil is unmistakable. Yeah, I do recall some undead types being in here. Oh, but I need you. I need you, Torch. Don't forget that I can drop them. You're no match for me, you horrible wolves. Oh, I hit R and it did it. Oh my gosh, R takes all. What? Is that? What? Does it really do that? Or did I just add a mod that lets me do that? Oh goodness. I hope it's a mod because otherwise I played this game for years and never noticed how to take all. Other than do it right here. Curious. Oh goodness, I really hope it's a mod added ability. Oh jeez. Okay. Oh crap, there are vampires here. Nope, Gwarn, you're a vampire hunter. You can do it. You're gonna affect me, and do I even have a cure disease potion? Oh, got one. I've got one. Hey, that should look quite nice. And they're not, like, blurry. You know, I'm going the right way. I can hear wolves. Come forth, Skelly. Yes. Come, Skelly. Oh crap! Ha 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 ha. I hate you so much. Oh jeez, alright. Oh, for real? I can only damage my own creature. All right, you horrible creature. Hey. Oh my god, R actually takes all. Jesus. I really hope I didn't. Scared me. What? Don't do that. You scared the bejeebus out of me. I can't make you carry a torch. You got my eyes. Is it really nothing? Screeching at me and stuff? Really? Be gone! Stupid. Oh, I didn't want a bone. Oh, but I can make bone meal out of it. Will you quit that? I do not like that noise you make. Well, what possesses you to make that? Freaking noise, but. Take no, that wastes way too much. Talking. There are only wolves in here. Alright. I'm getting somewhere. Lock the door with Agronauts or Serious TV. Silly of me to do this, but damn. Wish I could put that fire out. Honestly.
What?
No. Alright, Shine the Flare. Ooh, Crystal Weakness will actually probably help a lot. Ah! Alright. Be gone! Ah, shit! Ugh. What the heck? Blood Moon Dual Dagger. Damn. Lord Leviticus. Who the hell is this guy? Jesus. Okay. Okay, come on, Skelly, let's, slip through the door before it finished closing. I done trapped myself in here. There's no escape, which was quite literal. Okay. So, what's the vampire in here? Wolves just moved in? Let's see if we can't find some stuff. Lord Leviticus, what's he doing locked in here? It's a vampire that's right. Ah, better with suggestive drawings. No words can describe what you see, or what you think you see. Oh. What? Oh, jeez. You hit the button. Skelly, I really don't like you doing that. You should know this by now. Oh, did I not average? Oh! Man. Some books. Surprising that he didn't have any spells to use against me. Calipers. Ooh, is that blood in there? Ooh. Ooh, a chest. Bloodgrass. Okay, let's take everything. Aha. It's a marvelous. No. Ooh, hoo hoo. $3.99. Why is there a shovel in your oh, it's a cupboard. That's still a weird place. Ah, it's German. No, I have a spell for this. I need to use a spell. There we go. Oh. Better than nothing, I guess. Beauty, pure, and sublime. That is the only way to accurately describe my love. The maiden, grow, Malar. True, the orcs of Tamriel are often vilified by the other citizens of the Empire, and rarely would they be considered a pleasure to look upon. So, is my maiden love of a great breed of orc, unlike the rest of her kin in physical appearance? Nay, in fact, she's the perfect representative of her race. Green skin, muscular frame and all. But beautiful she is, all the same. For who am I to judge? Who am I to criticize when so many would condemn my very existence? Yep, I can only hope my love is as understanding when she learns of my unique condition, for I have yet to reveal that most precious of secrets. Damn the politics of my station. Taxation and trade negotiations. And meetings with disingenuous aristocrats. It's sometimes enough to make me regret my betrayal altogether. Spent the latter half of my life hiding my identity, guarding my secret. But now I am faced with an even greater challenge. For if word were to get out that I have fallen in love with a servant, and an orc, no less, I would be all but ruined, such as the life of a Cyrodiilic nobleman. Curse me for a coward. But I have not yet found the strength to tell my beloved Luck of the truth. Perhaps it's for the best, for what benefit is there in her knowing? She would share all of my fears, but none of my abilities. Her life would become one of doubt and uncertainty, still. If she is to spend her remaining mortal days with me, she has the right to know the truth. Joy and exultation, she is a child. My beloved Lopta is carrying my child. The midwife has predicted a boy, and we have already settled on the name Agrimad. In truth, I never realized such miracles were even possible. The divines have granted us their blessing. It just seems. And so shall it be. I just wonder, of course, if my dear child will share in my dark gift, and time will tell. Tonight, the truth will be revealed. I will tell my beloved Lutta everything. She will know who and what I am, and we will decide how best to raise the precious child that grows in the world. Trial! Foul and loathsome harlot! How dare Lepto question my motives? Question the love I have for my own unborn child. When she learned the truth that I, the Lord Leviticus, am no longer human, that I have locked Tamriel as a vampire for the past 200 years, how quickly she judged me. So I am a monster, am I? Perhaps I should have proven her right. Perhaps I should have drained her dry when I had the chance. But I loved her as deeply as a man has ever loved a woman. And I wanted nothing more than to bring our baby into this world, and embrace my new role as father. Perhaps when Lepto has come to her senses, or she refuses to come out of her room, we can have rational discourse about our future. I do not, however, retain much hope. Imprisoned in my own home while I slept. Lepto locked me in my own private chambers. She called to me through the doors, told me of her plan to escape with our unborn child. She means to keep my baby from me. When I get free, I will find the traitor Thor and rip the child from her very womb. 2 weeks have passed since Lepto locked me in my quarters. Try as I might, I cannot free myself. I cannot reach the doors. If I don't feed soon, I feel I will go mad. Food, blood. I need it. I need blood. Ooh. I discovered the journal of the Lord Leviticus. It does indeed contain information about Agronach's birth, but proves he was the spawn of a vampire. Agronach won't be happy to hear this, but it is the proof he wanted. I must take the journal to him at the Imperial City Arena Bloodworks. He will not be happy to hear that. He wants to be a vampire, I guess. Except the people who want to be a vampire. He didn't seem like a vampire. Yeah. You know what? Literature too. Disease? Wait, what was the potion I just picked up? Potion of Cure Disease. Okay. That was a great time to get it too. Oops. Ah! Resistance. I wish I had a horse. I'm not hungry, so. Not too shabby. Have to avoid collecting too much stuff in the lawn. Let's finally head out of here. I think there's one more area I can go and look through. And we should be good. Yes, maybe. Probably. Well, Agronach, you're definitely not gonna like the news I have for you. Not one bit. No? Yeah. Oh, don't want the bone. There's this area over here. Old wooden door to Crowhaven Burial Halls. You know what? Yeah, you know, I should clear out these vampires. I should. Yes. We'll go ahead and clear out these vampires. Oh. Oh, nope, there are zombies here. Go, Skelly, go! Ooh. Oh, jeez. Jeez, what the heck kind of weapon do you have? That's worth a decent amount. I don't want a steel bow. Oh man, what weapon was that? Hey. Give me your mace that was like wrecking up my stuff. Dang it. I probably blasted it way far away or went through the floor. Damn. I know I dropped a bunch of torches through the floor. Oh, that's nice. Don't even like it. At least I got some stuff off of it. I probably could have taken those grease, but it's not really worth it. Ooh, it's Malinus Frown. Oh, oops. I didn't mean to do that. Let's do that. Oh, come on. You scare me when you do that. Avoid doing that. Please. Nice. Well done, Skelly, well done. Ugh, zombies, ugh. Hello? Oh. My torch. Well, okay, I guess we did clear this area out. Sorry enough. There's only one zombie. There were three zombies. There's one vampire. That wasn't bad. We're good now. We're good. We can leave. Let's leave. This place is gross. Gosh, I hope I didn't contract any other diseases. That would be awful. Just awful.
I wish I could have gotten that mace or axe or whatever that vampire had. Whatever they had, it was enchanted, and I bet it was worth a crap ton. But of course, you know. Oh well. It seems to be Garn's luck.
Oh, really?
Oh.
Someday he'll be able to sprint in.
My magic isn't recovering, is it?
Why would it? A little water. Ankles right here.
Yes. Good, 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 good. Yes. Almost out. This is quite the underground area for a fort. He owned at least a small fortress. Well, yeah, I mean, I would consider this a small fortress, considering all the how big some of the fortresses are that I've seen. Oh, getting laid out, so I guess I'll be camping. Huh? Guess we'll set up camp here. Go ahead and check out the rest of this area. We've got some. No. Oops. Oops. I wonder who that's a statue of. Oh. And just dodge roll. Did a dodge roll. Yeah, this looks like we're good then. Search through everything. I don't see any other shots. So I guess we'll set up camp and then be on our way back to the Imperial City. To, get that Master Stonemason and tell Agronach the. Well, it's certainly not good news, but it is a type of news, so. You know? Whoa, whoa. Okay. Ooh. Alright, thank you. Oh, it's getting stuck on my screen, is it? Here we go. Oh, just some ooh, not for this one. I'll take some of you. Useful. Alright, yep, we'll be setting up camp. Let's see. There we go. Ho 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 ho! Fire! Ha! Huh? Okay. So let's go ahead. It's not bad.
It's not bad. Some bread, another apple. A little water. Let's see what we got.
Oh, Jesus.
Of course. Okay. Hopefully, yep, okay.
Alright, so, I guess that's it for this area. We'll be heading back later.
Bye.